إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدًا عبد الله ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. Brothers and sisters in Islam, قال الله تعالى, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, in Surah Al-Baqarah, حافظوا على الصلوات والصلاة الوسطى وقوموا لله قانتين. Guard strictly your five daily prayers, especially the middle one, and stand before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with qunut, a command from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to us to guard strictly our salah, our five daily prayers. Guard the times that we have to perform these salahs on or at. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّ الصَّلَاةَ كَانَتْ عَلَى الْمُؤْمِنِينَ كِتَابًا مَوْقُوتًا. The salah is to be performed in its fixed times. And the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam identified these times for us. So you guard your salah by performing it on its fixed times. You guard your salah by observing the conditions that you must fulfill before the salah, the prerequisites, and one of them, al-wudu, the ablution, al-ghusl, learning how. You also guard your salah strictly once it comes to the deed itself. And we know any deed in Islam has pillars, and the deed is invalid without these pillars. As-salah has pillars. If you abandon one of these pillars, the deed is invalid. The salah also has duties and has recommended acts. It all falls into the area of the command, guarding your salah strictly by learning all these conditions, pillars, duties, and implementing it. implementing them in your salah. Brothers and sisters in Islam, I'm speaking today to those who pray the five daily prayers, and also, and in particular, to those who do not pray the five daily prayers. And we know there are Muslims who do not pray five times a day. My message is for both of you. As for the first one, النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كما في صحيح البخاري ومسلم was sitting with his companions one day. A companion of the Prophet, صحابي, entered the masjid. فصلى. He prayed. And then he approached the gathering and he said, "Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullah." The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam said, "Wa alaykum assalam wa rahmatullah. Irja' fa salli fa innaka lam tusalli." Go back and pray because you have not prayed. You did not pray. This is the caliber of the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. سمعنا وأطعنا. What do you mean? I didn't pray. I prayed. لا. هذا هو الجيل. This is that beautiful generation. سمعنا وأطعنا. He went back and he prayed again. But he repeated the process. He approached the crowd again. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله ارجع فصلي فإنك لم تصلي. Go back to pray because you have not prayed. Again, سمعنا وأطعنا. He went back and he repeated the process. And he approached the Prophet and the gathering again. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله ارجع فصلي فإنك لم تصلي. Go back to pray because you have not prayed. Right here the companion said, قال والذي بعثك بالحق لا أعلم إلا غيرها. By the one who sent you with the truth, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that's all I know. I don't know any better. Teach me. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught him how to pray. الشاهد من القصة أو من الحديث, I'm quoting this hadith to let you know one thing, that you could be praying and you have not prayed. You're not praying. You see, one thing about this companion, he, radiallahu anhu, thought that he is praying. He prayed and his salah is correct. And this applies to a lot of Muslims now. A lot of Muslims pray, thinking that they are praying, but they are not really praying. And I'm not invalidating your deeds here. حاشا لله أعوذ بالله أن أكون من هؤلاء. لا. بس النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم restricted the salah in one simple statement. One, two, three, four words. صلوا كما رأيتموني أصلي. Pray as like you have seen me pray. He also, صلى الله عليه وسلم, told us, والحديث في مسند الإمام, من حديث عمار بن ياسر رضي الله عنه قال صلى الله عليه وسلم, والحديث حسن. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says, إن الرجل لينصرف وما يكتب له من صلاته إلا عشرها أو تسعها أو ثمنها أو سبعها أو سدسها أو خمسها أو ربعها أو ثلثها أو نصفها. A man will pray, someone will pray, and he finishes his salah, and he gets all what he gets in reward. The reward of the salah, we know the salah is five times a day, 50 in ajr. He gets out of that 10 hasanat, ushr, 1/10, 1/9, 1/8, 1/7, 1/6, 1/5, 4th, rubh, quarter, 3rd, half. My message to my brothers and sisters in Islam who are praying is to learn. Even if you're old, don't say, I've been praying. ما ينفع ما ينفع. العلم, the knowledge of the religion, some of it is fardu ayn, is mandatory. You cannot come in the day of resurrection and say, I did not know, O Allah. Especially if the mediums, the means to learn are available. فلرن how to pray. As for the rest of my khutbah is to my brothers and sisters in Islam who do not pray. And actually that statement is not accurate. My brothers and sisters in Islam who do not pray. And maybe I'll explain that. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم في الحديث المعروف المشهور, حديث عبد الله بن عمر, he named the pillars of this deen. والحديث في الصحيحين, you all know, بني الإسلام على خمس. Islam is built on five pillars. شهادة أن لا إله إلا الله, إقام الصلاة, إيتاء الزكاة, صوم رمضان, والحج. الصلاة is the second pillar of Islam. ولا يسقط عنك في أي حال إلا في حال الجنون أو فقدان العقل. الصلاة, you must perform it in any condition. The only excuse in the Sharia for a person not to pray is losing the brain. Or the sisters going through their women things. The cycle and the mens. The cycle and the post-delivery. طيب, here's five pillars that makes you a Muslim. الشهادة, one time you're a Muslim. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله, أشهد أن محمد رسول الله, you're a Muslim now. طب, let's leave the salah for a second. الزكاة قد تسقط عنك. There are some people who do not qualify to pay the zakah because they don't own the nisab. We know to pay the zakah you must qualify by owning the nisab for a hawl, for a year, 85 grams of gold, the values of which, or 595 grams of silver, whatever is lesser in value, you owned it for a year. If you don't have this, you don't have to pay zakah. As-sawm, fasting, قد يسقط عنك. Some people, they don't have to fast. Whether they are sick, whether they are traveling. الحج conditional to begin with. ولله على الناس حج البيت من استطاع إليه سبيلا. طب you tell me what is left there from Islam to you to perform? Just a name tag? لا ينفع. Not good, that name tag. That is why, brothers and sisters in Islam, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was called to the seventh heaven to receive the command of the salah. All the other pillars, by the way, Jibreel alayhi salam came down to earth with it. But the salah, فُرِضَتْ فِي السَّمَاءِ السَّابِعَةِ. حديث المعراج, حديث أنس بن مالك رضي الله عنه, والحديث في صحيح البخاري. Beautiful story. I don't want today to go after scaring you. And I tell you something, there are texts that scares once it comes to the salah. And maybe I'll scan through this quickly. والترهيب في ديننا, using the scare tactic, it's in our deen. Why did Allah spoke about the hellfire in the Quran? Why did Allah spoke about the punishment in the graveyard and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? I really would like my brothers and sisters in Islam today to reason and to make the right decision once it comes to their salah. في صحيح البخاري كتاب الرؤيا حديث سمر بن جندب, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said that أتاني آتيان, two individuals came and took me for a journey. It's a lengthy hadith. I just want the piece that I'm looking for. Those two individuals are Jibreel and Mikael. And they made the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam see so many scenes in the journey. And one of the scenes, رجل جالس, a man sitting down. And next to him, رجل قائم وفي يده حجر. And in his hand, another man standing next to him, and in his hand there is a rock. And then he would smash the head of that person sitting down until it becomes pieces. And then the rock rolls away, rolls away. This man, by the time he goes to pick up the rock and come back, he will find the head of this man back to its former state. Smash again. The rock picks. Smash. Repeat. هذا في القبر. This is in the graveyard. من هذا يا أخي يا جبريل؟ Who is this, my brother جبريل؟ ذاك الرجل ينام عن الصلاة المكتوبة. This is the man who does not pray the mandatory salah by sleeping. يا أخي أنا أعجب من هذا والله أعجب. The overwhelming majority of the Muslims know about this. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم, والحديث في معجم الطبراني المعجم الأوسط أو الوسيط, Hadith Anas ibn Malik radiyallahu anhu. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, أول ما يسأل عنه العبد يوم القيامة الصلاة. فإن صلحت صلح سائر عمله وإن فسدت فسد سائر عمله. The first thing that a Muslim will be asked about in the day of resurrection will be the salah. And if it is good, then we will deal with the rest of his deeds. Your understanding this hadith, by the way, while separating the scene here, the day of resurrection, 50,000 years long, all of mankind will rise from beneath the ground. In this dunya, they tell you 1 million man march. We were able to get 2 million people in one place. Can you imagine? Adam, alayhi salam, until the last soul born in this world will be in one place. Standing naked. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم والحديث في صحيح مسلم حديث المقداد ابن عمرو رضي الله عنه تدنو الشمس من رؤوس الخلائق مقدار ميل. The sun will be 1 mile away from your heads. The people will be soaking their sweat, some up to their knees, ankles, waist. Some will be drowning. Used to have somebody singing, Inni aghraq, 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 Inni atanafasu tahta al-ma, Inni aghraq. The same thing. He's like drowning. But he does not die. وَيَأْتِيهِ الْمَوْتُ مِنْ كُلِّ مَكَانِ وَمَا هُوَ بِمَيِّتِ. You're going to be refashioned to drown and not to die. The hellfire will be brought. وَجِيءَ يَوْمَئِذٍ بِجَهَنَّمِ فِي أَرْضِ الْمَحْشَرِ. People standing for years and years. قِيلَ نِصْفَ يَوْمٍ. It was in one of the ahadith, والحديث في صحيح ابن حبان, حديث أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه, that it will feel for a kafir like half a day, 25,000 years. Or a disobedient. The people actually will go to the prophets. Can you please intercede for Allah to begin judgment? We want to move out of that miserable condition. We just want judgment. We want reckoning. That's what we want. Reckoning, judgment. They are asking the intercession of the prophets for judgment. Shafa'atul Anbiya for judgment. And the shafa'ah will lead to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Qala sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, wa ana awwalu shafi'in wa awwalu mushaffa'. And look at this now. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala comes to judge. And the first question in the test is the salah. Ya Allah, ayy aql hada? You tell me. Standing for 25 years. Now asking the prophets to intercede before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In order for Allah to come in a way that fits him subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then the first question you will be asked is salah. And if it is accepted, then I will deal with your zakah. We'll deal with your fasting. We'll deal with your enjoining good, forbidding evil. If it was not accepted, then. But I tell you, on Monday, you have a test. If you pass that test, you're going to get $100 million. And the first question in the test, you must answer. Otherwise, and here is the question. أول شيء How dare you? And wallah, I say this because I love you for the sake of Allah. And I care. And again, I'm not trying to scare you. But I'm just trying to reason with you. This is a serious matter. كل نفس بما كسبت رهينة. Every soul will be held accountable for everything that they've done in this world. إلا أصحاب اليمين. Except the people of the right. The believers. في جنات يتساءلون. They will be in gardens. They are asking about المجرمين. And they will ask them, ما سلككم في سقر؟ سقر جهنم. وما أدراك ما سقر؟ لا تبقي ولا تذر لواحة للبشر عليها 19. سقر جهنم. ما سلككم في سقر؟ What got you into جهنم? The first one. قالوا, they said, لم نك من المصلين. We did not pray. Brothers and sisters in Islam, فويل للمصلين. ويل, a threatening language. In some of the books of tafsir, a valley in Jahannam. To those who pray. الذين هم عن صلاتهم ساهون. Those who are not mindful of their salah. Listen to this carefully here. Are not mindful. ما أحد فسر هذه الآية بأنهم لا يصلون. No one explained this ayah that they did not pray. بل ثبت موقوفا عن سعد بن أبي وقاص رضي الله عنه. They used to delay the salah. Delay the salah. ويل if you delay the salah. What if you do not pray? Remember at first I said my message to my brothers and sisters in Islam who do not pray? And I said I'll explain that. Because your Islam is in question. And I'm not going to go over the debate here. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم والحديث في صحيح مسلم من حديث جابر بن عبد الله رضي الله عنهما بين المؤمن وبين الكفر وفي رواية والشرك ترك الصلاة. What is between a Muslim and kufr, shirk, not praying. وفي مسند الإمام من حديث بريدة رضي الله عنه العهد قال صلى الله عليه وسلم. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says العهد الذي بيننا وبينهم الصلاة فمن تركها فقد كفر. The covenant between us and them is a salah. But there is a debate between the scholars and I choose not to get there. But again, if you're not praying, you fall into two categories. Kafir, fasiq. Yaqi, how would you like to fall into one of those two? And some scholars said, huwa yakfur. إذا كان مستحلا. You ask him why don't you pray? He tells you, صلاتي يا عم. They have a lot of time at their hand. 1400 years ago, it's a busy time now. والعمل عبادة عم الشيخ. Work is عبادة يا شيخ. يعني إيه المشكلة؟ وبعدين is not in the Quran. Five times not in the Quran. هذا هو. But somebody tells you, استغفر الله إن شاء الله, make دعاء for me. Why would you fall into this, brothers and sisters in Islam? أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. الحمد لله رب العالمين, له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل, وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له, يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل, وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدًا عبد الله ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. You know the last words that came out of the mouth of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, someone who delivered to the ummah the Quran and the Sunnah. You know the last words that he used to say as he is leaving this world? As-salah, as-salah, as-salah. تقول أم سلمة رضي الله عنها والحديث في سنن ابن ماجه آخر كلام خرج من فيه الصلاة وما ملكت أيمانكم, الصلاة وما ملكت أيمانكم. سبحان الله, if someone you love leaves you with a وصية, with a will, here is وصية محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم to you. What are you doing with it? Salah, brothers and sisters in Islam, Sila, the word Salah is derived linguistically in the language, derived from Sila, to connect. Salah connects you with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You literally connect, and I don't mean physically, but as you pray, you're speaking to Allah. You're standing before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. يعني في صحيح البخاري, في صحيح مسلم, حديث أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه, الحديث الإلهي, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, Allah سبحانه وتعالى says, قسمت الصلاة بيني وبين عبدي نصفين. I have divided the salah between me and my slaves into two halves. نصف لعبدي ونصف لي. When you say الحمد لله رب العالمين, Allah says حمدني عبدي, my servant has praised me. ولذلك يسن الوقف من السنة أن الإمام يقف, وأن كنا نخالفها أحيانا, the sunnah that the imam stops ليسمع. There is a huge big relationship between توحيد and الصلاة. ولذلك لا يترك الصلاة إلا من توحيده في كلام. Imagine in every salah Allah tells you حمدني عبدي الرحمن الرحيم أثنى علي عبدي, my servant extolled me, exalted me. مالك يوم الدين مجدني عبدي, my servant glorified me. إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين, thee I worship, thee I ask for, you alone I worship, you alone and I ask for help. You know what Allah says? ذلك بيني وبين عبدي, this is between me and my slave, and I know what my slave is looking for. ولعبدي ما سأل, and I'll give it to him. I know what he's asking for. He's asking for help. And I know what area he's asking for help for. I'll give it to him. Subhanallah. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم في حديث الحارث الأشعري والحديث في سنن الترمذي وقال الحاكم على شرط مسلم حديث الوصية يحيى ابن زكريا بني إسرائيل If you pray do not look around وذلك سبحان الله a person who stands in صلاة لا يرفع رأسه you should not be looking up لينتهين أقوام If you do not stop raising your head up when you're praying, lightning will take your sight away. Because you're standing in front of Allah. You're standing in front of Allah. When you stand in front of some human being who has a status in this dunya, you stare. Yes, brother. Yes, brother. You don't look around. He will say, look at me. You don't look around. Brothers, sometimes they pray. إن الله ينصب وجهه لوجه أحدكم في صلاته فإذا صلى أحدكم فلا يلتفت الله سبحانه وتعالى looks at you when you pray so do not look around الخشوع stand with submission you look to where you prostrate in humility and humbleness الصلاة الصلاة I want to close with this قال صلى الله عليه وسلم لأصحابه ذات يوم والحديث في البخاري ومسلم أرأيتم لو أن نهرا بباب أحدكم يغتسل فيه كل يوم خمس مرات Imagine a river surrounding your house that every day that you bathe in this little, is in this river five times. Do you still have هل يبقى من درنه شيء? Do you still have any dirt on you? قالوا لا يا رسول الله. They said no, O Messenger of Allah. He said صلى الله عليه وسلم ذلك مثل الصلوات الخمس. The likeness of this is the five daily prayers. تحترقون تحترقون you burn burn with sins gossiping backbiting and then you come to pray ظهر cleanse عصر cleanse مغرب cleanse عشاء cleanse فجر cleanse قال صلى الله عليه وسلم والحديث صحيح مسلم حديث أبي هريرة الصلوات الخمس the five daily prayers والجمعة إلى الجمعة ورمضان إلى رمضان Friday to Friday جمعة to جمعة مكفرات لما بينهن إذا اجتنبت الكبائر They expiate the sins as long as you avoid the major sins Brothers and sisters in Islam حافظوا على الصلوات والصلاة الوسطى Guard strictly your five daily prayers قال صلى الله عليه وسلم when he was dying الصلاة الصلاة the will of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم to you what are you doing with this command and what are you doing regarding the will of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم a question that I ask you and you answer between you and Allah